Good evening, everyone. Welcome to GradeUp's MBA Prep channel. So after these all these examinations of 2020, some of you must have just started your preparation for CAT 2021, and some of you must be preparing for other examinations. Okay, so DI is one of the integral parts of all the MBA examinations, be it CAT or other MBA exams, right? Especially in CAT, you have really difficult DILR sets. But in other examinations, you have some basic DI, right? Wherein they the conventional DI that you have, graph based or maybe some table based, right? Or those sorts of DI. So those DIs, I'm talking about non-CAT, and plus sometimes in CAT, this year they did not have any such, mostly they were logic based, right? If you have those calculation based DI, you have certain concepts for them, right? And we are going to discuss such concepts in this session. Okay, so I'll discuss that. What are the things that you must master in order to excel in those conventional DI sets? Okay, so good evening, everyone. Welcome to the session. If you are new to our channel, please do subscribe to the channel so that you do not miss out on any important updates related to any of the MBA examinations. And if you enjoy our sessions, you can like our sessions too. Okay, so GradeUp has come up with a course for CAT 2021. If you are starting your preparation now, you may enroll in this course, which is a comprehensive course for CAT 2021. It will be taken in the form of live classes. We'll provide mock tests, sectional tests. Okay, it will also include GD, VAT and PI preparation and revision workshops before the actual examination. Okay, so taken by expert faculty members. For that, you just need to subscribe to GradeUp Super Subscription and get access to the test. Okay, all right, so let's begin with the first concept that is very important. These concepts will help you in quant as well as in data interpretation. Okay, so when we talk about data interpretation, the conventional data interpretation, wherein you have questions based on graphs and tables, and what are the things that you need to master. Okay, so if you talk about percentages, one important thing is percentage change. Now this will help you in all arithmetic based things like profit loss, simple compound interest, everything, right? So percentage change is what? Percentage change in value is change upon initial value divided by 100. Let's take a simple example. Okay, suppose let's say in November the price of potato was 40 rupees per kg. Okay, now in December the price becomes 50 rupees. What is the percentage change in price? So what I told you, the change upon initial value. So what is the change? Change is of 10 rupees and initial value was 40. So the change is 25%, right? Now suppose in January, the price again becomes 40 rupees. What is the percentage change from December to, January? Now the change is of 10 rupees and the initial value was 50. So 10 by 50, which is 1/5, that is equal to 20%. Okay, so whenever you have to compare percentage change, you have to compare with the previous period. Okay, and you take the difference and then you find with respect to the previous period. Okay, so this will be 20%. Okay, now questions on percentage increase. Let's say the price of some item was 900 rupees and it increased by 15%. So how do you calculate this? You say that 900 into 1 plus A by 100. So basically 115 by 100. Okay, so you add 100 plus that percentage by 100. Okay, so that you will get 1035. Similarly, if I say that a bag was of rupees 2000 and it decreased by let's say 22%. Okay, so 100 minus 22 is 78%. So you take 78% of that. Okay, so 100 minus that particular percentage, you will get 1560. Okay, so this is percentage increase, percentage decrease. Okay, if you have to calculate those. Alright. Okay, then one important thing in percentages is you should know the reciprocals of numbers. Right, sometimes this comes very handy. Right, instead of writing 25%, you can write 1 by 4 also. Okay, instead of writing 1 by 15, you can write 6.67%. Okay, so these numbers you know interchangeably, at least up to 20 you should know, that helps you a lot. Okay, if I say like if I hear the number 12.5%, that should automatically come to my mind as 1 by 8. Okay, so I mean make this list, right? You can, for now you can take screenshot, right? Save this, write it somewhere and then practice some problems using it, and you will realize that it becomes quite fast to solve questions, right? When you know these conversions. Okay, then one important thing in percentage thing is approximation of fractions. Okay, so what does approximation of fraction mean? Okay, so approximation of fraction is like, suppose I'll give you an example, right? Like let's say you have to calculate this value. Let's just write some random value upon 4772. Okay, suppose I have to find approximate percentage of this value. Okay, how do we do this approximation? Okay, sometimes you have approximation DI, like some of you might be writing IFT as well this time, right? So there they ask such questions wherein you have to approximate the values. Okay, now what we do is, first step, make the denominator calculation friendly. Now can you divide by 4772? Does anyone know the table of 4772? No, right? But we know the table of 5. I can easily divide a number by 5. So what I do is, I make the denominator calculation friendly. Okay, now next step is, I have to find the percentage change in the denominator. So when I made this 5000, okay, so let me write like this. What was the change I made? I made a change of 228. Okay, 228 is approximately what percentage of this number? 228 is what percentage of this number? Now 5000, 1% is 50, 5% is 250, right? So this is slightly less than 5000. So I can say it is approximately 5% of this number, isn't it? See, we are approximating the fraction, right? I'm not saying that exactly 5, approximately 5%, right? Then what you do is, apply the same percentage change in the numerator and calculate the answer. Now what will I do? I added 5%, so I will add 5% on numerator also. Okay, now 3651, like let's say 3600, let's treat it 3600, 1% is 36, 5% will be 180. Okay, so what we do is, we add 180 to it. Now what do you get as a number? You will get 3831, right? Or you can treat 3830 also, does not matter, right? We are approximating. Now I have to find this. Now I do not know divide by 4772, but I can divide by 5, right? What is 383 by 5, right? Just focus on the digits. What do you get? You will get 76.6. See, I mean, this is this should be less than 100%, right? So that will be 76.6%. 76.6%. Try this value using a calculator. I mean, if you have a calculator with you, calculate this value using a calculator, and you will be surprised to see that you are getting a very close answer. Okay, without even using a calculator, you can get a very close answer to this. Okay, so with practice, I mean, try with some random fractions, try putting some fractions and finding these percentages. And or like if you have questions to practice where you have such numbers, try practicing and you will realize that you can master this concept like anything. Right? Did anyone use a calculator to calculate it? Right, let me just calculate using a calculator and see what is the actual value. 3651 divided by 4772. So it says 76.5088. Right, it is 76.5088. That's the actual value. Right? But my answer is 76.6. Right? Will they give much closer option than this? Right, it is coming 76.51, right? But my answer is quite close to it. They won't give such, I mean, such close options. They will give options like, let's say, they will go options like 74.9, 75.2, 76.5, 77.2, like this. They will give such options, right? They might give such options. So you will, even if they give these close options, you can still mark your answer, right? So see, it might not be 100% accurate, but quite close to it. Alright, so isn't it a good way to solve things, right? You can, you can do these calculations much faster than, I mean, solving using some other method, right? Okay, so let us look at some concepts. Okay, let's see that how these concepts can be utilized. Okay. Now the first question is, what is the percentage change? So it shows the interest rate on loan. Okay, the first question asked is, what is the percentage change in the rate from 2015 to 2017? What is the percentage change from 2015 to 2017? Okay, suppose this is a theta question. You are given some graph like this, and you got a theta question like this. 15 to 17. I just explained you this concept. Let's see if you recall it. So in 2015, okay, let's just write the values. In 2015, this is 10%, right? And this is 15%. So what is the percentage change? So natural answer would be 5%, right? Some people would say 5%. Very natural thing, 10 to 15, you say 5 is the change, right? But no, what I just taught you, that percentage changes change upon initial value into 100. Okay, so change is for 5, right? Initial value was 10, so 5 by 10 is 50%. 5 by 10 is 50%. Okay. Then the second thing, what is the percentage point change? The thing which people would answer for the first thing, that is called the percentage point change. Percentage point change will be 15% minus 10%, that is 5%. Right. The percentage point change is the difference. And percentage change is a change upon initial value. Okay, so the answer to the first question is 50%. For the second thing is 5%. Okay, so Divyanshi, please just refresh it. You should be able to see it. Okay, so percentage change is the change upon initial value. And if you talk about percentage point change, that is the absolute difference between those values that are given to you, the percentage values that are given. Okay, so this is about percentages. Now let's say you get a graph like this. Okay, I've given you the values also. So it shows the GDP of two countries from 2014 to 18. The question is, in 2017, the GDP of B was what percent of the GDP of A? And these are kind of questions you get in all examinations, not only in CAT. Yes, in CAT you have majority of the questions which are of higher level, but this is the basics that you must be thorough with. Okay. So in 2017, the GDP of B was what percent of the GDP of A? I just told you the method. Okay, what you have to find? GDP of B, which is 4570 upon 5150. Okay, you have to find this value and tell me what will it be. Now see, the options are quite close: 85.4, 86.9, 88.7, 89.8. Right? You cannot just guess like this. But the method that I just told you, that would help you in solving it quite fast. Okay. Now see, what I have here is 457 upon 515. Right. So I can say that I'll make the denominator calculation friendly, that is 500, right? So this, with practice, you will get it very instantly, right? It will not take any time to solve. So 500, that is minus 15, that is 3%. You decrease this by 3%. So decrease this by 3%. What is 3% of 4.57? Right, 13.5, you subtract 14, let's say 14. So what do you get? You get 443, right? When you just divide 443, you will get 886 as the digits. So the closest option that you see is 88.7, right? Marked answer as 88.7, isn't it? You can simply get the answer 88. You got 88.6. Now you do not argue that, no, I got 88.6, the option was given as 88.7, because you are approximating. This is not 14. Okay, this is slightly less than 14. So this will be more than 443, right? So this will be more than 88.6. So why to worry about that? You do not have to break your head into this. No, I got 88.6, it is 88.7, right? Just calculate whatever is the closest value. Now these are, now initially the options, when you saw, they looked close, but now they look far apart, right? So your answer is 88.7%. Okay. All right. Then another important concept in DI is ratios. Okay, you must have seen in XAT, some of you might have appeared for XAT, there were questions which were based on ratios. Okay, so you should know how to deal with ratios. Okay, calculating common ratio of three or more terms should be some familiarity with you, right? You should be familiar with calculating the common ratio. Suppose if I say A ratio B is 4:5, and A ratio C is 6:11. What will be A ratio B ratio C? How do you find that? A ratio B is 4:5 and A ratio C is 6:11. Okay, so find A ratio B ratio C. What will be A ratio B ratio C? What we do in this case is, A ratio B is 4:5 and A ratio C is 6:11. So what we do is, we take LCM of the common element, right? Common element is A. LCM of 4 and 6 is 12. Okay. Now 4:5 can be written as 12 ratio. I mean, I can make it three times, right? So 12:15, and this is 6:11. So 6 2s are 12, 11 2s are 22. So this will be the ratio between A ratio B ratio C. Right, so this is how we take ratios of three or more elements. So we take the common whatever the variable is there, we take the LCM of the corresponding values and then equate the ratios. So 4:5 is equal to 12:15, right, and 6:11 is equal to 12:22. So you write 12, 15, and 22. Okay, all right. One thing that you must remember, I mean, this is not only helpful for DI, but for quant also. So there are, so what we studied, like just percentages and ratios, these are relative values, right? Percentages are not standalone values. If I say some percentage, it will be some percentage of something, right? If I say 80%, 80% means what? It has to be 80% of something. If I say ratio, ratio will be some between some numbers, right? These are not standalone numbers. So these are relative values. They are related to some other number, right? So one golden rule you remember, if a question has absolute value, the options have absolute or relative values. Okay. Let's say if I tell you that the age of three people is given to you, I ask you what is A ratio B, or if I ask you the sum of the ages of these three people. So absolute values. Questions options might have absolute or relative. So you will have to calculate the answer, right? Now, suppose the question has relative values. Okay, the options are also have relative values. You can assume any calculation friendly value. I'll give you an example. If I say, let's say A ratio B is 3:4, right? And I increase A by 20%. And B by 10%. Okay, so what will be the new ratio of A ratio B? So what will I do is, now I do not know, now you should not worry what numbers should I take, right? Okay, so let me take A as 30, B as 40. 20% increase, that will mean 36, and this is 10% increase, that will mean 44. So 9:11, I will say. So you can assume any calculation friendly value. So if even if I take 30:40, if I take 90:120, I will get the same answer. Okay, so you should not worry about these. Take any calculation friendly values, right? So whenever you get such questions wherein you have relative values in the options and relative values in the question as well, you can assume any value to solve the question. Okay. And finally, if the question has relative values and the options have absolute values, right? If I say that salary of A ratio B is equal to 5:6, and if I say, right, if I say that expenditure of A ratio B is equal to 3:4, and if I ask you that saving of A, saving of A minus saving of B. Can you calculate this? Because you are given just ratios, right? You are not given any absolute value. So if no absolute value is given in the questions, you cannot determine the answers. Okay, the answer would be cannot be determine. Okay, so in case you encounter such questions, not only in DILR, but DI, but also in quant, you need to remember these things. Okay, all right, so let us solve one question, right? So this table gives you that there are three types of plants: marigold, rose and sunflower in five gardens. Okay, the given table shows the percentage of plants died, the ratio of marigold, rose and sunflower which are still green, and the number of marigold plants which are still green. So certain percentage of plants died. Of the remaining plants, they have given you the ratio of these three and they have given you the number of marigold plants, okay, which are green. Okay, and you have to find the ratio of the number of dead plants in garden B and garden C. Let's see if you can comprehend data from this. Okay, so a good amount of data given. You have to use that to solve it. So Kushagra, previous year, see, in DILR, if I say that nothing is sufficient as such, I mean, the more you do, because see, yes, of course, you should go through past year papers, but whatever sources you get, like, let's say, GradeUp as a platform, other places also, if you get some good DILR sets, okay, try solving them. Okay, so take your time. Maybe even if you take, like at this stage, even if you take 40 minutes, 45 minutes to solve a set, go for it, right? But try to complete those sets. Okay, because DILR is something you need to know some basic techniques. Then apart from that, it's just practice. Like if you practice a good number of questions, okay, and at a later stage, practice in a timed manner. Because if you look at this course, like if in if you see the 99 percentile, it was at 34 out of 72 marks, right? So if someone was able to do around 11 questions, would have secured 99 percentile in the section, right? Just 11 out of 24. How decide a DI set of good quality? Okay, so first you will have to see some sets, right? Solve some questions. Then you will get a taste that which one is good or which one is bad, right? So initially, go through past year papers and all, right? So gradually you will get an understanding which one is good, which one is bad. Okay, that understanding will take time. All right, I'll just solve this question. The ratio of the number of dead plants in garden B and garden C. Okay, so we have to deal with these two. So forget the other three, right? Now B, you have 243 marigold plants. Now marigold, rose and sunflower is 24, 34, 37. So what are the ratios, sum of ratios? 98, right? 27, 34, 37, 98. This is 116, 182. Okay, let's say, talking about B, 27x is equal to 243. I have to find 98x, right? So what will be 98x? X will be equal to 9, right? 98x will be 882. Okay, now 16% died. Okay, you have to tell the number of dead plants. 16% of died, that means 84% survived. Okay, 84% survived. Now in this 22% died, so 78% survived. Okay, now 84%, 882 is 84% in B, 882 is 84%. I have to find 16%, right? What will be 16%? 1% will be 882 by 84 into 16. All right. Okay, so this is 4 by 21. Okay, you will get 21 into 4, 84, then 42, 2. So that will be 168. In B, 168 plants died. In C, you have 53x, because this is marigold, is this one, right? So 53x is 159, right? So x will be 3. You have to find 182x. 182x will be equal to 546, right? Now this 546 is 78% of the plants. You have to find 22%, because 78% are the alive plants. Okay, so you will get 546 into 22 by 78. Okay, so that should be 39 1 15 156 4, that is 154. This is 154, right? You have to find the ratio of 168 and 154, that you will get as 12 ratio 11. Okay, so lengthy calculations, right? Lengthy calculations and ratios, but that's how we do them. Okay, that's how we find the ratios. Okay, yes, Divyansh, we shall have a course for that as well, like repeaters batch. Okay, all right, so let's let's solve one question. Let's say, suppose this is a data interpretation graph given to you. So it shows the number of visitors in a museum on 5 days of a week. The table gives the ratio between the number of men and women and the ratio between the women and children visiting the museum on different days of the week. What is the difference between the number of men visiting the museum on Thursday and Friday? Suppose you have to find the number of men visiting on Thursday and Friday. So what we will do is we will take the combined ratio. Okay, so we will take combined ratio of all these three, right? So we get on Thursday and Friday. So Thursday is 7, 8, 4, 5. So men, women and children, right? 7:8 and 4:5. So what do we get? We get that 8, this will be 14, no, this will be 8 only, so 8 for 8, that will be 10, okay? And so in this case, there will be the men, women and children ratio is 7:8:10. On Friday, it is 4:3:6:7, so common will be 6, this will be 8:6:7, okay? That's what we saw. How to find common ratios. Okay. So on Thursday, you will have 7 out of 25, 15 plus 10, 25, and the number of visitors is 550. And that you will get as 154. Right. And on Friday, you have 8 out of 21 and the number of visitors is 630. 30 times, so 30 into 8 is 240. Okay, so they've asked you the difference. So difference would be 86. Okay, so you have to in this question, you had to take the common ratio of three elements that we just discussed, how to find the common ratio between three elements, and then calculate the number of men using that ratio and get the difference. Okay. All right. Then another thing that is important for data interpretation, building data interpretation skills, is averages. Okay, so you should know how to find the average. Okay, average is basically sum of numbers upon number of items in the set, right? Or alternatively, you can say that sum will be equal to average into number of items. Okay. Now, one important concept that is tested in quant is average something, right? Here it should be multiplication. Okay, change in sum is change in average up into number of items. Okay, so how do we do this is that can be done in a simplified way. I'll give you an example of this. Let's say the average height of 17, these kind of questions sometimes are asked in quant in different examinations and they can be taken quite easily, right? People do it by a long way. Let's see how can we do it in a simplified way. Okay. The average height of 17 students is 149 centimeter. If the height of the teacher is all included in the average height increases by 1 centimeter, find the height of the teacher. Okay. So what we do in this case is, first we find the, we'll say, suppose the teacher is also 149 centimeter. Okay, if the teacher was 149, then what would happen? The average height would remain as 149 only. Okay, and number of people is now 18. So 17 plus teacher, that is 18. Okay, now we know the change in average. Okay, average height increases by 1 centimeter. We know the change in average. We know the number of people. So we have to find the change in sum of the heights. Okay, so change in average is going up by 1 and number of people is 18. So the sum should go up by, the total height should go up by 18. Okay. So the total height, like if including the teachers, so the students are fixed, right? We know their heights, right? So we will increase the height of the teacher by 18 centimeter. So that height of the teacher would be 149 plus 18, that is 167 centimeter. Okay, so if the teacher is 167 centimeter high, the total, the average will increase by 1 centimeter. Let's look at the reverse scenario wherein we use the change in average concept. So a cricketer has an average score of 54 runs in 9 innings. If he scores 84 runs in the 10th innings, what will be his average after 10 innings? Okay. Now suppose he scores 54. Suppose he scores 54. What he scores 54, so his average will remain as 54. Right? And number of innings is now 10. Okay. But what happened? He scored 84. Right, actually he scored 84. So what was the increase in his score? So sum increased by 30, right? And number of values is 10. So average should go up by 30 by 10. So that is 3. So average will increase by 3. So his average was 54. Now it will be 57. Okay, his average will now be 57. Okay, so this is how we use this concept of average sum relation. Clear? Okay, so now let us see some like how it is used, these things are used in data interpretation. Okay, let's say you have to find the average number of books sold. So suppose you are given a graph and you are asked the average number of books sold. Okay, so these are the values that we have. Okay, so I'll give you that there are four pointers. The values may not be clearly visible in the graph. So I'll give you these values specially because these values at least you can read. Okay, I think these values are not clear. So I'll tell you what these values are. Okay, so actually there are four lines in between, right? So the values in this case is not actually increasing by 4 but by 5. Okay, so if there are 4 equally spaced lines, so this value is actually 945. This value is correct. This is 895. This value is 905. This value is 865. And the last value, okay, these values can be read. This is 925. Okay, so I have written these values. Let me write the others also that can be easily read, by the way. 960, this is 920, and this is 840. Suppose I ask you to find the average number of books sold over the week. Okay, so will you add all these 7 numbers and divide by 7? That's what average says. Right, average says that total upon number of values. Isn't it? So there are 7 values and you will add those and divide by 7. But no, there is a better method called deviation method. Okay. So how to find using deviation method is you assume some average plus minus deviation by number of values. All right. So let us see what does it mean. So let's say if I look at these values 960, 940, 920, 895, 865, 905, 925, 840. If I ask you, what do you think will be the average? Just a guess. Some logical guess, what should be the average? Just then, by looking at the values, what do you think should be the average? Like close value, right? What you can guess? I mean, it is not necessary that it has to be correct. Right, you just take some educated guess by looking at the values. The values range from 840 to 960. Some are below you get as high as 945 as well, and then you have 865. Any rough estimate on the average? Like, suppose you do not have time to calculate. Okay, so Manoj, yes, correct. You take 900, right? Because it looks like average net 900, right? So what we will do, we'll assume the average as 900. Okay? Now we will find deviations. How to find deviations? Value minus average. Okay? So the deviation is 60. Here it is 45. Here it is. This is actually not 920. My bad. That is not 920 because, I mean, it is here, right? So let me just check if I have done error anywhere else. 4, 5, 6, 7, right. So that was 920. Then 920 was not there. It is 895, right? So this is minus 5. This is minus 35. This is plus 5. This is plus 25. And this is finally minus 60. Okay, so what we will do, we will just take the deviations. We'll add these deviations, right? So minus 5 and plus 5 gets cancelled, okay? And then I have 60 minus 60 that gets cancelled. 35 minus 25, okay? And plus 45. So that will be 10. Okay, 10 plus 25, total deviation is plus 35. Okay, plus 35. So what will I do? 900 plus 35 by number of values is 7. So my average will come out as 905. Okay, so average will be 905. So this way you can calculate it faster. And remember that it is not necessary that you take 900 only. Okay, you can take 910 also, 920 also. But generally, I mean, as a rational person, you should be able to get some close value, right? If you take 910, you will get the correct answer. Okay, you will just get minus 35 and you will divide it. Okay, so as B. Shiva says, 920. Suppose you took 920 also, don't worry, you will get the correct answer in that case also. So 920 if I take, okay, so what will be my deviations now? If I take 920, the deviations would be this is 40. This will be 25, right? This is minus 25. Okay, this is minus 55, minus 15. This will be 5 and this will be minus 80. Okay. All right. So minus 25, 25 gets cancelled. Then I have 45 minus 55 minus 10. So I get minus 25 minus 105 minus 105. So 920 minus 105 by 7, right? That is minus 15. 920 minus 15, you will again get the value as 905 only, right? So in this deviation, you can assume any value which is reasonable. Okay, don't take 950, right? Obviously, you will take somewhere 900, 910 in that range. You will get the correct average. Okay, all right. Okay, so let's say there's some data given to you. A batsman played 8 matches and had a batting average of 41. The bar graph shows the number of runs scored by him in each of the matches. Runs scored by him in the first match were twice of the runs scored by him in the 8th match. How many runs did he score in the 8th match? So these are the type of data interpretation which you might get, right, in CAT, less chances because nowadays they have started asking logic based, but still, like if you get 8 sets, they will definitely have 1 or 2 sets on conventional DI also. Okay. But definitely helpful for other examinations. And these are the basic building blocks of DI, like how you find average, how to use, solve for percentages, how do you solve for ratios, etc. These three things will help you master arithmetic also, and also the calculation based DI. and what we saw how to find approximate percentage. So all these things are covered in this the basics of calculation based DI, I would say, and the basics of some arithmetic as well. Okay, so he had average of 41 and 8 matches. So whenever you see number and average, okay, so just come up with this that you should find the sum, right? Sum will be 41 is the average into 8, that will be 328. Okay, now what is given to you? You are given these values. Okay, how to add values quickly, that also I should tell you. Add values that pair up to 10, right? Like 45 and 85 you should add together. Okay, so only one pair, okay, not an issue. Then if you get multiple players, try to pair numbers like this. So 85 you will get 130, 169 plus 29 would make it 198 plus 22 is 220. So we know the total is 220 in these matches. Okay, now first match were twice the run scored by in the 8th match. So this is x2x, right? Total is 328, right? 220 plus 3x is equal to 328. So x will be equal to, so 3x is 108, x will be 36. What do you have to tell? Score in the 8th match, that will be 36. Isn't it? That was just a simple thing that how they can test you on basics of averages. Okay. All right. So this was something. These are the basics that you need to master. Okay. So you can, the ones who joined late can watch this video again to get the basics of percentages, ratios and averages that you need to be thorough with in order to excel in data interpretation. Okay. I'm sure you must be aware that we are going to have a CAT conclave on MBA conclave on 16th and 17th of January, in which we have certain eminent speakers like Chetan Bhagat, who is a famous author, and Sriharsha Majethi, who is the co-founder and CEO of Swiggy. And we have many more elite personalities from the business world who will be delivering talks, who will be telling about their journeys at their respective B schools and their careers ahead. So it is very, these sessions are very valuable for the students who are preparing for MBA. So they get to know how they spend their life at B schools and how did they manage to get success in life. Okay. One announcement that if you are preparing for CMAT and Maharashtra CET examinations 2021, we are launching a crash course. Okay, the enrollments have begun. This is going to be in Hindi, right? So we will be teaching, the content will be in English. The mode of communication will be in Hindi. And this is for CMAT and Maharashtra CET, which are the upcoming MBA examinations. In order to enroll in any of our courses, you need to you will need to get the GradeUp Super subscription, through which you can access all the courses that we have for different MBA entrance examinations. These are our different subscription plans. Let's say if you are preparing for CET and CMAT or GDPI, right? So you can enroll in the three-month subscription plan, right? Or if you are preparing for CAT 2021 or other MBA examinations in 2021 and 2022, right? So you can enroll in the 12 or 18 month subscription plans. Okay, so you can check out our plans. So those who are preparing for these MBA examinations can enroll in these courses for their preparation. Okay, these are our mentors. They need no introduction. I'm sure you must have met them on our YouTube channel and GradeUp app and know that how well they are with their subjects, most of them being 100 percentile or at least 99.8, 99.9 plus in their respective sections. Okay, so that's it for this session. I hope you enjoyed the session. So please do like the session and all the best with your preparation. We are always with you with your preparation. Okay, and start early if you are preparing for CAT 2021. Start early. That's a better like if you start early, that is definitely going to give you better results, and we are always there to support you with your preparation. So that's it for this session. Thank you for attending the session. Have a great day. Goodbye.